hey,
what's going on? It must have to go like that. So hey out there, hope there's not too much background noise going on here, but I figure before I do anything in this truck, I need to get rid of this broken glass. Right? Right? So I saw a couple videos on YouTube on pulling the windshield out, right? Here's some specialty tools. First gotta take this trim out. Got all these little clips and stuff. I'm not exactly sure how they clip on, but I did pop them off. I got this tool right here that kind of works. And a guy on the video I saw, I think it was Eric, the car guy. You know, he's a professional. Yeah, he popped this in, pulled it around, popped the window off, you know. But you gotta hook this little end in. It's right there. Under the glass. Yeah, just wedge it between the silicone or whatever it is sealer on here and the glass, and that'll cut it. You gotta basically cut it loose. So I got this side loose. Now the top, I can get it wedged in there, but it's not going anywhere. You're supposed to like pull it with this and just kind of rip through it, right? It ain't ripping nothing. Is to use a scraper like this. See? Metal scraper. From the inside. That's what I got to do now, so. I'm gonna try it. This shouldn't take me all day. It's taking way too long already. All right, so is this gonna work? I don't know, I hope so. I like to break this. Once I break this off, then I can get the vacuum in here and start cleaning this place up. Right now, there's glass all over the place. Nice little tiny ones on the seat and stuff. On my butt. So let's see here. Yeah, that's what these are for. Safety first, right? Let's see. Hope this works. I'm tired of screwing around. Soapy water. The guy on TV said. Well, the sound system still works. Unfortunately, I'm missing the knob on that brand new head unit. It's gotta be in there somewhere, right? Or it's on the side of the road somewhere. guess what? Got me. Cut through the knuckle of my glove. Just right there. Not too bad, but I'm trying to get it to stop bleeding. I had to put some peroxide on it, running water, salty water, and it's still bleeding a little bit. Figures. Well, once I get it stopped bleeding, I'll put a band-aid on it. Continue on. I'm almost there. I got that little corner to do there. For new welding gloves anyway, right? All right, just for your information here, I am using a rigid, I forget what this is called. I bought this a couple years ago. It's a reciprocating saw, but it's a, it's small. You can use it with one hand. It's got a very short stroke, and it's perfect for something like this. It's called an oscillating stroke. I think that's what it's called. But it's got the little switch here, and it gives you just a straight up and down stroke. And with that, it gives you a kind of a little circular type thing. And then the scraper is in Milwaukee. 1-inch blade scraper. So far, everything's working great. A whole lot easier than that window removal tool from Harbor Freight. That thing I could wedge in the glass, but I could hardly get it to cut, man. It took me, an hour to do one little side? Screw that. I'm